Salam alaikum. Good morning. Firstly, allow me to convey my gratitude to the Secretary General of CAICID for his dedicated efforts in carrying out the center's different programs and for the great work that has been done so far. I would like also to thank Saudi Arabia as the promoter of the initiative and Austria as the host country. Spain is especially pleased with CAICID's achievements since the first step in the process of its creation was taken with the Madrid Declaration at the World Conference on Dialogue organized by the Muslim World League in 2008. And we stand ready to keep our support. It is of the utmost importance that we hold this meeting on rejecting violence in the name of religion and protecting religious and cultural diversity in Iraq and Syria. The violence perpetrated in the name of religion in Iraq and Syria threatens the historical, social, and religious fabric of coexistence between Christians, Muslims, and other groups in the region, and the survival of religious minorities. The presence of high-ranking religious leaders from the region at this meeting is proof of their commitment to peace and ending violence. Interreligious dialogue for a culture of peace is a priority. Religion is perceived by some as the source of tensions. This perception hides the root causes of the problems, which are political or social, rather than the religious. Religion is not the problem. On the contrary, it can be part of the solution. Religion can be a peacemaker and a peace builder. Religions have more similarity than differences, including shared values and teaching of peace and forgiveness. The Middle Eastern religions share a common goal of peace and can coexist. We need dialogue between religious leaders to aid peace and counter violent extremism. We need a platform of religious leaders in favor of peace and networks of religious actors engaging in specific activities and projects aimed at fostering peaceful coexistence, respect for religious differences, and collaboration on shared problems. We have to take action at the local and regional levels if we want to be efficient in the pursuit of peace. Local religious leaders have enormous influence. They can reach diverse audiences, militants, tribal leaders, leaders of other religious communities, and local actors, because they are respected and trusted by their communities. Local ownership of respect for religious and cultural diversity and peace-building process is critical. Local leaders can agree to establish peace zones and to work together to resolve conflicts without violence. Religious leaders also have an important role to play in supporting action at the regional level, including regional interreligious dialogue. Regional and subregional organizations also play crucial roles contributing to stability, security, and peace. The Organization of Islamic Cooperation is essential in fostering cooperation in conflict prevention, mediation, and intercultural dialogue, and in promoting and facilitating the resolution of different conflicts in the Middle East. We have to show determination to address the problems that we face through action in all relevant fields: prevention, protection, education, and the promotion of mutual respect. There are several tools at our disposal. Let me present you three. First, peace education and conflict resolution programs should be included in schools, universities, and communities. These programs should include religious peacemaking techniques, especially those that draw on religious texts and traditions. Amidst growing religious extremism, it is essential to establish training in religious peacemaking for students of religions. Second, it is essential that the media be used as a channel for dialogue and for promoting positive images of religion. Religious leaders need capacity building and training in media and information literacy to improve their ability to access and use the media and social media to promote dialogue and peace-building initiatives. The voices of peace have to be heard, and in the media, and they have to use social media to launch campaigns on dialogue and common citizenship. Third, in civil society, women and young people are important shapers of religious activities that reject violence and support peace. Women can successfully promote intercultural and interfaith activities within their families and communities. Today's young people will be tomorrow's leader. We have to foster interfaith dialogue programs and activities for young people outside schools, such as sports, arts, or games, where students from different backgrounds can understand and appreciate religious and cultural diversity within their community. Finally, I would like to underline that achieving religious tolerance and non-discrimination is not just a task for Iraq and for Syria, but also for the rest of the world. Spain is currently reforming its criminal code to include new legislation that criminalizes all acts that directly or indirectly incite hatred or violence based on religion, national origin, or race, including antisemitism. We publish books about the teaching of Islam for state schools and mosques. We also have a barometer of the opinion of the Muslim community in Spain to give public administrations a better understanding of these communities' perceptions and values, eliminate stereotypes, and promote integration and mutual understanding. I would like to finish by making reference to Islam's long history of nonviolent teachings and practices. Indeed, one of the 99 names of God in the Quran is As-Salam, or the author of peace, safety, and security. And peace is one of the basic meanings of the root word from which the term Islam itself is derived. Islam teaches peace. Thank you very much.